Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
For the Japanese Akita, it's supposed to look regal and dignified. It has to look fierce, but not aggressive. So it's just the look that to scare off, say, a bear, but not scaring people away either. I know it's a fine balance between the two, but yeah, that's the ideal of a Japanese Akita. It is a national treasure of Japan. So that's what we shoot for. They were originally meant for hunting, so you have to have that fierce look to it. But not overly aggressive, not fearful. And yeah, you don't want the Labrador personality, although there are a lot of our dogs that have the Labrador personality, but it's not, ideal. But I know a lot of breeders, we kind of breed for that now because there's no reason to be that fierce anymore, at least in the United States. But that, for the most part, I think the regal, dignified, fierce look is what we shoot for. The Japanese Akita personality, it varies. A lot of times they could be, aloof. They want to be in the same room with you, but they don't want to be right next to you. They're not a cuddly dog, typically. They can be. They have the guard dog trait in them, so they'll follow you around the house, but they're not going to be sleeping right next to you. They could, but typically not. Energy level, typically they are lower energy level. You would think they'd be more energized because they're historically sled dogs, hunting dogs, so forth. But at this point, they're typically not too high energy dogs. They'll exercise, but a lot of times they'll tell you, man, let's go back. Now, any dog can be trained to do anything. So yeah, you could, we have members who take their dogs hiking and all types of sports, but your average dog, after exercises, they'll tell you, they'll stop, they'll pull on the brakes and say, let's go home. Yeah, it's pretty important to socialize a Japanese Akita Inu. Because it has that fighting dog history, you want to make sure, depending on your situation, what you want to do with your dog. But if you want to be, greet people at your house without putting the dog away, yeah, it's very important. From the day one, as soon as you get a puppy, I would socialize your puppy right away. Unless you want the guard dog thing going, it's pretty important. Get to know sights, sounds right away. Some people fear diseases on that, but there's always different environments that you don't have to be scared of, like you shouldn't take the puppy to a dog park, sure, but there's other environments that's safe for a puppy to socialize with people and other dogs. So our dogs typically aren't barky dogs to begin with, so it's kind of deceiving that they're, but they can be, because they have that dog spirit, yeah, they want to socialize right away. Obedience training is, Japanese Akitas are pretty smart dogs, so they're pretty easy to train obedience-wise. You have to know your dog, so high-end treats, when they know when they're tired, look for cues on your dog. But if you give them a reason to do something and look at their energy level at the time, yeah, they're very easy to train. There's nothing they can't do for a Japanese Akita, Yeah, life living with Akita, probably the biggest thing anybody should know is the fur. You have to vacuum and sweep the fur all the time. If you don't like a lot of fur, you shouldn't get a Japanese Akita Inu. Aside from that, yeah, just a constant companionship. The famous Hachiko story of being loyal, always being around. So that's always nice. The dog is always with you wherever you go in each room. So there are other stories that probably should get more press. But Hachiko is the famous story where a professor in Tokyo got a dog named Hachiko from the home of Akita's Odate City, Akita Prefecture. And he was a professor at a university, and unfortunately he raised him up to for a little bit, not a long time. His name was Dr. Ueno. Unfortunately, he passed away, but every time Dr. Ueno goes to work, Hachiko would follow him to the train station, every morning and wait for him till he gets back from the train station to come back home. Every working day. And then one day, unfortunately, Dr. Ueno passed away at work. But Hachiko was always waiting by the train station ever since. Unfortunately, he stayed there till the day he died at the train station, waiting for Dr. Ueno. The biggest two health issues that the Japanese Akita face is something we call sebaceous adenitis, or SA, and something called VKH. They're both autoimmune diseases. Autoimmune meaning your immune system attacks yourself. So it's not like a virus or bacteria. So SA is sebaceous adenitis. That's where the dog's immune system attacks their sebaceous glands on their skin, typically associated with itchiness, losing a lot of fur, and a bad odor. And the other one's VKH, again, the autoimmune disease where the dog's immune system attacks the orifices of the dog, which is the nasal passage, the eyes, the ears. Anywhere there's an opening in the dog, that manifests itself. Yeah, research is being done. No cures. There's treatment to do for both. So it doesn't kill the dog, both of them. So you have to manage the symptoms. And typically dogs live quite a long time. But there is, at this point, no cure. And it's the fact that the American Akita also has the same issue means that those two particular diseases are pretty entrenched in the breed. The only thing that, and this is not scientific, the only thing I prevent it from happening is preventing the dog from getting very stressful situations is how I usually see it manifest itself, and which is typical of an autoimmune disease. Oh yeah, life expectancy of a dog is about 10 to 12 years old. Maybe let's say it's 12, but 10 to 12. Could go as high as 15, could be younger. Oh yeah, if somebody was interested in the Japanese Akita, I would probably direct them to our website, Japanese Akita Club of America. It has a list of breeders and more information of the breed. I mean, you should do your due diligence before you purchase the dog, because a lot of people assume every dog is gonna be like a Labrador Retriever, and that's not the case. So do your due diligence, and then contact the breeders at the website. Again, Japanese Akita Club America, or JAKA as we call it, is the way to go. We also are on Facebook too, and there's a public page. And the Akita Club America North America branch, or Akiho North America branch, we also have a public page as well. So basically there's two clubs in America that you could address. But the biggest one is probably Japanese Akita Club America, and the other one is Akiho North America branch, or Akita Inu Hozonkai.